Shalom, everybody, and welcome, and happy secular New Year to everybody, both here in our sanctuary and on Zoom. We're very happy to be together this lovely early winter evening. It's a small group tonight. I really would encourage everybody to move up and sit closer, if you would.
Promise we don't bite.
No? Okay. So, just as a reminder, that just in case of an emergency, there are exits all around, on both sides, in the back. There's a door up here on the bima, and there are hearing assistance devices and large print prayer books on the table by the entrance back there. Tomorrow, there's going to be Torah study on Zoom only because our offices are going to be closed for the next week to give our staff a well-deserved little vacation. So, again, glad to have everybody here. I'm Judith First. I'm here with Adria Sherman. We're representing the board. If you need anything, feel free to ask us. And Cantor and Rabbi.
Thank you.
Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
We begin on page 12 of our prayer books, the Hunar Anana, come let us sing. Is there a better way to begin Shabbat? I don't know, Rabbi, if there really
is.
I don't think so. Karma fana betora bismirot naria lo
Shalom. It is wonderful to be together this evening. We're so glad to have everyone here and on Zoom. This Shabbat is a Shabbat of blessings, and that's the theme that I hope that we can all hold into the new year. Our Torah portion this week is filled with blessings as we complete the book of Genesis, Parshat Vayechi. Jacob is reaching the end of his life, and so what does he do? He blesses. And as we reach the beginning and the end of this year, this calendar year, 2023, we don't mind. Jews, built into our calendar, we have four Jewish New Years. We don't mind adding a fifth secular one to celebrate, too. And so as we move into this secular year, I hope that we can bring these blessings that Jacob gives to his children, his sons, his grandchildren, and we can celebrate a Shabbat of blessings. So to begin and officially welcome in Shabbat, we will light the Shabbat candles. We invite to the Bima Dale Lesney. We're on page 2.
As these Shabbat candles give light to all who behold them, so may we by our lives give light to all who behold us. As their brightness reminds us of the generations of Israel who have kindled light, so may we in our own day be among those who kindle light.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam Asher kitshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu le'hadlikner shel Shabbat.
We continue with our Kabbalat Shabbat songs and prayers and psalms. We are on page 17 with the words of Romemu. Please join in.
Romemu Adonai Eloheinu Veishtachavu Lehar Kodesho. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu Veishtachavu Lehar kodesho ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu romemu Adonai Eloheinu veishtachavu Lehar kodesho, romemu Adonai Eloheinu veishtachavu. Lehar kodesho, ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu. Ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu romemu. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu veishtachavu lehar kodesho. Romemu Adonai Eloheinu veishtachavu lehar kodesho.
Page 20. Yalalalalai lecha dodi. Yalalalalai lekakala. Yalalalalai p'nei Shabbat, p'nei Shabbat nekabla. Yalalalalai lechadodi, yalalalalai lekakala. Yalalalalai p'nei Shabbat nekabla.
Shamor v'zachor. Ki ishmiyanu el hamyuchad Adonai echad ushmo echad L'shem utiferet velitila Yadadai yalalalalai lechadori Krakala Yalalalalai P'nei Shabbat P'nei Shabbat Nekamela Likrat Shabbat Lechu V'nelcha Ki Mekor Habiracha Merosh mikerem nesucha So ma'ase memachshava tehila Yadadai, yalalala life nei Shabbat, nei Shabbat nechamela. Kitoreri, kibaure. Daveri ki voranai laich nigla yararai yalalalai lechaduri yalalalai lekakala yalalalai pnei Shabbat pnei Shabbat nekamela. Shalom Ateret Ba'ala Gam Besimcha Uvsohola Toch Emunel Am Segula Bo ichala, bo ichala, yararai, yalalalai lechadori, yalalalai likrakala, yalalalai pnei Shabbat, pnei Shabbat nekamala. Yalalalalai lechandodi, yalalalalai likakala, yalalalalai pnei Shabbat, pnei Shabbat nekamela.
Indented Hebrew on page 22.
Tzadik katamar yifra. Keres balvano iske shetuli beveraronai bechatrot Eloheinu ya.
As we remain standing, I invite you to turn to one another and greet each other. Shabbat Shalom. Give a wave around the room. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. We can do some waving too.
Shabbat Shalom. Shabbat Shalom to those on Zoom. Hello.
Shabbat Shalom.
We now remain standing for the words of the Chatzi Kaddish. We just concluded our Kabbalat Shabbat with the words of Tzadik HaTamar, the special psalm for Shabbat. And now we move into our Ma'ariv evening service with the words of Chatzi Kaddish on page 26.
Yitkatav yitkarash shmei rabba.
Amen.
Be'amadi v'rach yirutev yamlich machutei Mechayechon uv'yamechon uchayedecho bed Yisrael Ba'agala, ba'agala uv'isman kahariv v'imeru, amen Yeheshmei rabba mevarach ve'alamu amehamaya. Bye. Yiparach v'yishtabach V'yipa'ar v'tromam v'yinaseh V'yitarar v'yitale V'yitalal Shemeir kursha g'rechu Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata Tushbechata v'nechemata Da'amiran be'alma V'meru ame
simple swaying of the heart in song and poetry, in the yearning to reach beyond the walls of self, I find the moment where I have stretched every muscle of my soul and my fingertips touch the boundaries of heaven. It's a healthy longing to dance with the divine. In a silent scream of terror caught in my throat, where a grunt barely audible is stifled, we try to breathe through suffering. In exclamation point of sadness, confusion of wonder, we find the perpetual question of the spirit. So, we pray alone or we pray with others. We pray though we are not sure who is listening. I pray because I am sure that my prayers are heard. In the hissing of the midnight wind, in the flapping of the wings returning home from the south, in the empty stare of dismay, and in the wrinkles of my eyes as I smile, O God, hear.
Baruch atah Adonai, Ha'ma'ariv Aravim. Ahavat Olam, Beit Yisrael. Adonai Elohim. to le olam va'ed ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha ve'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha היום על לבביך, ושיננתם לבניך, ודיברת בם, ושיבתך בביתך, ובלכתך בדרך, ושוכבך ובקומך, וקשרתם לאות על ידיך, והיו לתותפות בין עיניך, וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובשעריך. למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותי, והייתם קדושים לאלוהיכם. אני אדוני אלוהיכם, אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים, להיות לכם לאלוהים. אני אדוני אלוהיכם, אדוני אלוהיכם, אמן.
You may be seated. Where has this week vanished? Is it lost forever? Will we ever recover anything from it? The joy of life, the unexpected victory, the realized hope, the task accomplished. Will we ever be able to banish the memory of pain or the heaviness of boredom? On this day of Shabbat, let us keep for a while what must drift away. On this day, let us be free of the burdens that must return. On this day, Shabbat, abide. Help us withdraw for a while from the flight of time. Contain the retreat of the hours and the days from the grasp of frantic life. Let me learn to pause, if only for this day. Let me find peace on this day. Let me enter into a quiet world on this day. On this day, Shabbat, abide. We turn now to the words of Micha Mocha. We're on page 40 as we sing that song of redemption.
Who is like you, Adonai? Who is like you,
Bye.
Shelter us in place. Shelter us in peace. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in place. Shelter us in peace. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in love. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu L'shalom. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu L'shalom. Shelter us. Shelter us in place. Shelter us in peace. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in place. Shelter us in peace. Shelter us in love. Shelter us in love. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu L'shalom. Hashkiveinu Adonai Eloheinu. Hashkiveinu L'shalom. V'shamru b'nei Yisrael. Shani Amim Asadonai Asadonai et Hashemayim ve et Haaretz Vishamru b'nei Yisrael et Hashabbat la'asot et Hashabbat l'dorotam berit olam uvayom hashvi.
Everyone now to rise as you are able. We are on page 46 for the opening words of our Amidah. I'm holding on to those words, sheltering us in place, in love, and peace as we begin our prayers.
Adonai sifatai tivtach ufi agiteh ilatecha. Adonai, open up my lips, and my mouth may declare your praise. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu, Elohei avoteinu v'imoteinu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohe Yaakov, Elohe Sarah, Elohe Rivka, Elohe Rachel, Elohe Leha, Ael Hagadol Hagibor Hanora, El Elyon, Gomer Chasadim Tovim, Vekonei Hakol, Vizelcher Chastei Avot Vimahot, Umivigula Lifnei Vneihem, Leman Shemo Be'ahava. Melech Ozer Umoshia Umagein, Baruch Ata Adonai, Magen Avraham Vezrat Sarah, Atagi Borlelam Adonai, Mechayea Kol Atavrav Lehoshia, Mashiva Ruach Umorir Agashem, Mechakel Chayim Bechesed, Mechayea Kol Merachamim Rabim, Somech Novlim Berofech Olim, Umatir Asurim, Umekayea Memunato, Lishenei Afar, Baruch atah Adonai Mechayei HaKol Atah Kadosh V'Shimcha Kadosh U'Kadoshim B'Chol Yom Yehallelucha Sela Baruch atah Adonai HaEl HaKadosh.
You may be seated. As we prepare for the words of peace with Shalom Rav, I'll share a reading for peace and a prayer for peace as we have kept Israel in our hearts and minds, all the more so in this time of war. We hold Israel in our hearts as we say these words of peace. For the return of peace. O peace, you fleeting dream. O justice, you fickle hope, today we do not pray in your name. Today we pray in the name of the children who have never met you, who have not been blessed with your love or your truth. Surely their cries must someday drive you out of hiding, summoning you to cast your healing upon all the earth. O God, ancient and merciful, justice and peace are yours. Halt their retreat from the world and send them to us for good. Do it for the sake of your name. Do it for the sake of your right hand. Do it for the sake of holiness, for the sake of your children, so that all may live in the fullness of your gifts as one family on earth under your canopy of love. We turn to the words of Shalom Rav on page 60.
Shalom Rav, O Yisrael Amcha, Tassim Le'olam. Shalom Rav, O Yisrael Amcha, Tassim Le'olam. Ki Atahu Shalom Rav,
A moment now for quiet prayer. You may peruse the words of the book or offer some of the prayers that are within your heart.
Page 62.
Oh, say shalom, b'romav, u'yaaseh shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imeru.
Words of peace, we now turn our thoughts to those in need of healing. On the screen are names of those in our community in need of healing, and we hope that our presence together sends out a signal into the world to let them and their families know that we are holding them, and we pray on behalf of them and all of those in our hearts. If anyone is thinking of someone else that you'd like to share their name as my hand passes through the congregation.
Thank you.
We hold all of these names and these loved ones as well as those who we're holding in our hearts. We join together for these words of healing. We're on page 253 for the words of Misha Berach.
Misha Berach Avoteinu Mekor HaBracha Leimoteinu May the source of strength who bless the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing and let us say Amen. Bless those in need of healing with refuah shelema, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us
we pray for complete and full recovery in whatever way possible. And together we all say, Amen. Amen. Sometimes I think the words of Misha Berach are some of our most holy words and prayers that we can offer together as a community. And I'm glad we're able to be together to recite this tonight. Happiness has a lot to do with our expectations. So this week in the final Torah portion in the book of Genesis, Jacob and his son Joseph teach us something about happiness and expectations. But we already know that happiness and expectations are related. When you go out to eat at a new restaurant, your friend raved about it. You're excited, a new spot. The anticipation can raise your sense of happiness throughout the day. But then you find the food mediocre and you're disappointed. Reality fell below expectations. If the food was good, as you'd hoped, you'd feel pleased and content. On the other hand, when something good happens that's unexpected, well, that's the gold. The restaurant turns out to serve the best eggplant parmesan you've ever had, and the chef pops by with a complimentary pumpkin souffle. Yeah, all right, let's head there after this. Research suggests that we want to have realistic expectations because accurate expectations are useful for making good choices. When we have realistic expectations, we know what to anchor on, we know how to decide things for our own benefit for others. Unrealistic expectations, on the other hand, set us up for disappointment. But we also know that setting the bar too low doesn't work out so well for our happiness either. So what does that have to do with Jacob? Jacob is very old. He knows he is at the end of his life. The Torah tells us that Jacob is ill. And like his father Isaac, the Torah tells us that Jacob's eyes had grown dim. He could no longer see. Joseph, one of his sons, has a very high station in Pharaoh's court and comes to his father's bedside to see his father Jacob and to receive blessings before Jacob dies. Vayomer Yisrael el Yosef, and Israel, or Jacob as we know him as well, said to Joseph, Ro'apanecha lo pilalti, I never expected to see you again. Vehine Hera oti Elohim, and here God has shown you to me, gam etzar echa, and let me see your children as well.
Later, Jacob offers other blessings to Joseph. Jacob blesses that God will be with Joseph and that Joseph's descendants will be blessed. But I believe this profound statement that Jacob says to Joseph, I never expected to see you again, and here God has let me see your children as well, that this statement and insight is one of Jacob's most important blessings. Years ago, Joseph's brothers had told Jacob that his son Joseph had died. We can see that even at the end of Jacob's life, he's still recovering from the loss that he thought he had experienced. He thought he had experienced the death of his son. He still feels connected to that grief that he'd carried for so long, even if that grief was misplaced. But Jacob's language is profound. He says, to see your face, Joseph, I never expected it. But I think the Hebrew is even more profound. The Hebrew word pilalti shares a root with the word to pray. In Jacob's grief, he was so afraid to be disappointed, so afraid of that unfulfilled expectation. The Torah says he never even prayed to see his son again. Rashi, a commentator, elaborates on that sentence and that says that what it means is that Jacob never even dared to cherish the thought that he would see Joseph's face. And yet, Jacob thanks God that not only did Jacob get to see Joseph, but he met and he blessed Joseph's children. Jacob gets to see a whole generation that he never thought would be. This experience is so powerful for Jacob that Jacob blesses his grandsons, Ephraim and Manasseh, before blessing his own children. So Jacob's lesson for us today is nuanced. We know that we need to live with reasonable expectations. But I believe we cannot live like Jacob, never dreaming of certain possibilities. We cannot hide forever in our grief, no matter how important it is to grieve, and no matter how much it might consume us. We cannot always set the bar so low that we never even dare to pray for the possibility of something great. I believe that Jacob's most important blessing in this Torah portion, and trust me, he gives a lot of blessings, is this insight that comes right before the blessing, his formal list of blessings. I think through Jacob, we are learning that sometimes we have to open ourselves up to possibility. Jacob never dared to pray that he would see Joseph. He felt it was too unrealistic of an expectation. And so as our calendar year turns from December to January, from 23 to 24, I wonder, how can we open ourselves to possibility in this new year? Yes, we need some realism. We need to protect ourselves from disappointment. But for our most important dreams, those things that matter most, how can we extract from Jacob's lesson? How can we dare to pray for what we hope will be? Shabbat Shalom. I hope we can carry that lesson and others into 2024. We're going to move into our concluding prayers for the service. We're on page 282. I invite everyone to rise as we turn to face the ark for Aleinu.
Leinu l'shabeach l'adon hakol latet gedula leotzei breishit shehuna teshamayim v'yoser aretz u'moshav yikaro bashamayim mima'al u'shchilat u'zo b'govhe meromim hu Eloheinu ein od va'anachnu korim u'mishtachavim u'morim Lifnei Melech Malchei Hamlachim HaKadosh Kadosh Baruch Hu. Ve'ne'emar ve'haya Adonai le'melech ha'aretz b'yom ha'hu, b'yom ha'hu, yihye Adonai echad u'shemo.
You may be seated. We turn now to our mourner's Kaddish. To take the first step, a reading by one of my teachers, Rabbi Ruth Sohn. To take the first step to sing a new song is to close one's eyes and dive into unknown waters for a moment, knowing nothing, risking all, but then to discover the waters are friendly, the ground is firm, and the song rises again out of my mouth. Come words lifting the wind, and I hear, for the first, the song that has been in my heart, silent, unknown, even to me. As we share the names of those who we are remembering in a period of mourning or a yahrzeit, I invite you to rise at your seat as you are able when you hear the name of your loved one. We remember in the period of Shloshim, Julie Greenberg, the sister-in-law of Betsy E., Virginia Kolker, the mother of Ari Kolker, and we continue to remember Estelle Cohen, the aunt of Susan Seidenberg. And this week, we observe the following yahrzeits: Faye Berkley, Saul Birnbaum, Abraham Block, Robert Bright, B. Charney, Eva Cohen, Aaron Colbert, Jules Durlacher, Ronald Eisenberg, Norma Nettie Elkonen, Alan L. Gardetz, Bessie Ginsburg, Dorothy Golub, Betty Hutter, Ruth Cohn, Herbert Laster, Carol Lindenfeld, Simon Mitgang, Nancy Narr, Stephanie Orbach, Stanley Platten, Molly Pogach, Louis Rosengarten, Herbert Schrobe, Helen Schwartz, David L. Weber, Benjamin Weinstein, and Celia Zidden. We hold these names and we now invite the entire congregation to rise for the words of the mourner's Kaddish. We're on page 294. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabah.
Amen.
Be'alma di v'rach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei. Be'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael. Ba'agala uv'izman kariv v'imru amen. Yehe shemei rabah mevarach le'olam ulamei amaya. Yiparach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnase. V'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shemei dekudisha b'richu. Leila min kol birchata v'shirata. Tush bechata v'nechemata. Da miran be'alma v'imru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shemaya. V'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael. V'imru amen. Ose shalom bimromav, hu ya'ase shalom, aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. We say, may their memories be a blessing. You may be seated. I'd like to invite a Board Member 2, the Bhima, we don't have any closing announcements. You heard them. Judith covered them beautifully at the beginning. Thank you. So we now get to close with a song we haven't sung in a while. Would you like to introduce any words?
Yes, indeed. So we will be on page 321 for Adon Olam, but as you may know, the melody for Adon Olam is one of those things that can fluctuate based on the season. And as we come upon our secular New Year, our Gregorian New Year, we might say, there's this particular folk song that is most often associated with this particular time of year.
To our words of our closing benediction. May God bless you and protect you. May God's face turn towards us with compassion. And may God grant you peace. Shabbat Shalom. Please join us in the back for Kiddush and Motzi.